you want a better way to do lazy context loading and maybe run a few scripts in OpenCode, and you're trying to figure out what's the best way you can do this similar to Claude Code skills in OpenCode. If so, then this video is for you. We're going to be tackling OpenCode's new skill feature that just dropped a few days ago. I'll talk how you should set up skills, the limitations, and some interesting examples of how you can actually think about customizing skills for different parameters. Anyway, let's jump straight in and let's go. All right, to start with every video, if you want to find where the documentation for all of this is, just go to the OpenCode docs, scroll down, and you'll see this agent skills feature. This was released literally about 3 days ago. I'm just going to jump into it quickly. So it's very similar with every other OpenCode feature. It's a single file, got .opencode skill, and then the name skill.md. This is the most important thing to note. It's you have to do the skill.md part, and this is the actual main skill name. So when you're defining it into your .md or your config, it's this name that you need to use. Just keep that in notes. It's a little bit confusing, but it's important to note that's how the skills is. So it maps to this name and then maps to that skill ID. Not the best, but it works. All right, we also need to talk about discoverability with skills. So to start off with, it looks in your local project. So it'll look for any file in a skill folder. So essentially, if it's in .opencode, it'll look for skills, and then it'll look for that skill.md. And if it's in a .claude, it will also look for that skill.md along the way. And then lastly, it will check your globals to see that it is there. And this is all loaded in to OpenCode. One thing I do want to state is all skills are available to all agents. How OpenCode is handling it, they're not loading the context from the initial prompt, but they're telling the agent, hey, they can use a tool to actually search for the available skills that are available to it. So very important to note, if you do want your OpenCode session to use a kind of skill, you're going to have to specify use skill and then the skill name, and then it will use the tool to search for the skill and then load it into context. So it works a little bit differently than Claude, but hopefully you understand what I'm talking about. All right, just to jump to the code, let's just have a quick look. So I've got this OpenCode skills folder main here, and this is a way for me just to demonstrate how skills are made and some different concepts that you guys can consider. Essentially, I've got a few different skills. I've got a hello skill, step skills, TS skills, workflow skills, and smart router skills. Essentially, each of these is just a way I can demonstrate how you can think about using skills in a different variety of manners. But essentially, hello skill is exactly what it sounds like. It's just your skill that runs a bash command, says hello from tier one skill. And the next one is step skills. So this is a way I can show you how to run certain things from a directory. So we can see we've got a script here, and we're just telling it how it should run the script, where it should run it from, and then just bash script essentially. And that's how it works there. Then workflow skills is essentially how do we run certain skills in sequence? Can we define it here, and will it follow it? And this is correct. TS skills is how do we run like a .ts, for example. And if I open this.ts, you actually see there will be some syntax errors because there is no bun runtime. And that's it in this folder. So you'll see in the skills here, we're telling it, hey, go to the base directory and then run it. And then that way it should pick up the bun package right there and run it with not a problem. So you might have to equate for the different packages or different scripts that you're running that you have the right, you know, environment to run it. Like, so for example, if you're trying to run Python, it might have to instantiate the Python environment and run it, etc. So, and the last one is the smart router skills. Essentially, this is a smart way I want you to think about how you could dynamically render different contexts or allow skills to change the way your agent works for a subsection. So everything works with the skill.md, as I discussed earlier, but let's just have a quick peek. Essentially what it is it's a character selection. So you can choose from Yoda, Tony Stark, or Sherlock Holmes. And depending on what's configured, it'll have a different outcome that goes through. And you'll see here I've got this config folder. And in this config folder, I've got a mission and I've got mission 1 and 2. So depending on what's defined here, it will determine how the rest are interaction. you know, what the rest kind of interact with. How does it pull that out? So essentially, it just allows us to dynamically alter how the skill will work. And then lastly, with all the skills, is how do you add this to an agent? Well, so this is take my codebase agent. This is from the Open Agents repo. I just use this agent if I'm starting with any repo. I just like working with it, and this is a quick, easy one I can grab. But essentially, you'll see there is no skills defined in here. What you'll find is OpenCode pretty much has like a skills like this, and then it's pretty much, it allows all skills from default. That's pretty much what it looks like under the hood for OpenCode. So it actually goes and picks up the skill definition. So when you're writing these descriptions here, this is actually pulled into OpenCode. And you, depending on how many skills you can have, that's loaded into context. So they say it's not going to add too much. I'm not a big fan of just adding things unnecessarily to context, but that is how OpenCode is doing it. Claude Code does it the same way, is it injects the definition of the skill and what the skill name is to the agent, so it knows that it exists, so then it can invoke it. So that's how it works. So let's have a quick look, you know, just to make sure my claims are true. So let's just quickly run OpenCode here. So I'm just going to fire up the terminal, and I'm going to run OpenCode. And I'm going to go to my codebase agent, and just to make sure I didn't leave that in. Yep, no skills are there anymore. So great. And I'm just going to go to the codebase, and I'm going to say, what skills do you have access to? All right. And it's pretty much just going to tell us all the skills that we've got defined here. So it's literally told us the hello skill, which is here. It's got the step skill, workflow skill, TS, and smart read. So all skills are getting picked up there. So if I just exit that, I'm going to run OpenCode again. And this time, instead of running the code base, I'm actually going to go to, I've got two different ones. I've got the small and the main. So this one, skills demo agent, without the small at the end, you can see pretty much has access to all skills. So it's pretty much the same as the code base agent, but we're explicitly defining it. The one thing you will notice here is I haven't defined the smart reader skill, but by default, it will be picked up regardless. So just to show you this, all right, so if we just go to the skills demo agent, so what skills do you have access to? And we can see it's pretty much giving us the same output. All right. So lastly, I want to run OpenCode once more, but I actually want to go to the small agent. There's a few key differences here. You'll see I allow it to have access to three skills, but I denied access to two skills. So let's just have a look if that's the case. So if we go to the small, you can see here it's the small, and I'm literally going to ask it the same question. And we can see it only giving us these three skill names back. And it's telling what it's about and the smart reader. All right, I'm going to tell it to use the first skill, hello, just so we can see how it works. All right, and we can see here it executed our hello script command, and it's got that tier one skill. And this is to make sure that works. We can see this is exactly what it ran. Perfect. All right, so now the other skill was, let's just see, we said it was the TS skill. All right, so this is running this one. And what did this do? This just pretty much ran our dot example TS from bun. And this just executes a few different things here. So let's just test this, that this works. Please use the TS skill. All right, and there we go. We can see it's running. It went to our open code and it just ran our example, and it ran without any issues right there. And that's the skill in action. All right, I'm not gonna show the main one right now because I wanna leave that to the end. All right, so I'm gonna open code once more. And I'm gonna go to the main, the skills demo agent here. And I'm gonna ask it to run the step skills, because that's the one we haven't seen yet. So I'm gonna ask it to run the step skills. Oops, I ran the wrong one there. All right, we're gonna go to the skills demo agent here, and we're gonna say What skills do you have access to? And we got everyone. So please run step skill. And we can see it's running each skill in parallel. So it's running our steps.sh. So if we go here, it's just running that. All right. So this ask it to run the workflow one. All right, so we're gonna run the workflow skills here. And we can see if we just scroll up, because it runs quite quickly, it will run each script in our order that we defined. Script one ran, script two, script three, script four, and lastly, script five. Oh, sorry, there's only four scripts here. So we can see it ran all four scripts and it executed it there. Perfect. All right. Now, so we've shown all these except for the main one. I want to leave that for last. But if we go here, if we go to the small, we can see I denied a few. Let's actually test if we can run this. You know, so this asks you to run the step skill. So I'm going to just change agents to the small here to see if we can still access it. Because this is in context, I'm very curious to see if it can run the skin. So I'm going to tell it to run the step skill. We can see it's still got the skill in context. So we understand tabbing through doesn't work. But if we go new now and we ask it, hey, run the step skill, does it actually work? No, it ran the wrong one. So it ran the TS skills. No. All right, and here we can see right here, access was denied. I had to explicitly tell it, hey, run the step skill. And it tried to access it and it was denied. And that was done through our permissions, yeah. And that was done through those permissions, yeah. And the same will work if I do with workflow skills. The only difference is if I can't change agents with the tab, expecting it not to have access, especially if it's already accessed that information and pulled into context. So it's a good key thing to note. Another thing I also want to state, if you are working with skills, this is something I ran into, but you'll see this indentation here, especially in the YAML. If the skills is not correctly indented in everything below, OpenCode does not tell you there's an error with skills. It will just work regardless and just assume that all skills are there. So be very careful when you are setting this up that it looks exactly like this. All right, lastly, I actually want to run, so I'm just going to get a new one here, and we're going to go to our small again, and I actually want to run the smart router skills right now, and we can see we've got this mission as one, and I think I'm going to ask to go as Yoda. All right, okay, smart. All right, so we can see it's loading the smart use, and it's telling us to choose a character Yoda, Tony Stark or Sherlock. I'm just going to say one, run as Yoda. And we can see, okay, it's running as Yoda. It's, okay, personality, Jedi Council, phase one, train the Padawans. Phase two, fortify the temple, defenses, council strategy session, mediation, ready to defend the public, we are. Perfect, okay. So we can see it's run through different things. It's defending the Republic. But now, what happens if we change this config here? All right, we come here and we change this to two. What happens now? All right, so this is C. All right, so it's telling us to choose again. I want to choose Yoda, so I'm going to just tell it, hey, one. All right, but now we can see loading Yoda's personality, and we see, hey, undercover operation, infiltrate the Sith. Study the dark side, establish a cover identity, gather intelligence, prepare for extraction, and it was undercover. And that was all done through that variable here. We just changed this mission to two. So the first mission was defend the Republic, and the second was infiltrate the Sith. And if we go to the scripts here and we go to Yoda, we can see if mission was one, this is when it ran. And if mission was two, this. So we managed to dynamically make this happen. And again, this will work with any of the characters that we talk about. The only thing is we kind of have to tell it to run the skill again, or it can just run the script and the script will pick up the config. But hopefully you guys get the idea with this. So I just wanted to show you how you can make this dynamic skill work for different use cases. But again, this is all determined by the agent. So if your agent is not smart enough to understand your skill prompt here, it will not execute in that order. And again, if you are over context loading it, it might not perform the way you want. And you're also injecting to whatever agent you have that consumes the skill and then acts on it. So there's a lot of little different variables that you need to account for when running skills and how the agent actually uses those skills. So you want to maybe, you know, do incremental tests and not load all the tests, all the skills at once in one agent and hope it performs the right skill at the right time. Especially if skills are very closely named to one another, the agent can get confused. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this quick introduction to OpenCode skills, how you can think about it, and how you can actually personalize it for your own development. Anyway, I'm going to leave the link to the repo down below. And please, if you find these videos useful about OpenCode, please hit that subscribe button. The support is really well welcomed. And thanks again so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Thanks.